Okay, so this is what you need to do to money nails. First, I got my nails tipped and prepped. I got my money pre-cut, and then I got some tweezers. I got an orange wood stick, clippers, of course, acrylic, and some rhinestones for the art. And how I put the money on is you have to moisten it in water like so to make it more pliable. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to do one of the money nails. I'm gonna wet the money. Dry it off slightly on your table towel. Then I'm going to take some of the clear acrylic and I'm going to apply that to the tip area where I'm going to be adhering the money to, so it gives the money something to stick to. And just a medium layer, not too thick, not too thin. And just apply that. And the brush that I'm using is just a brush that I got from Sally. I like it because it's pretty big. And it holds a lot of liquid. I can work faster with it. So I just pick up the tweezers and put the money on the nail. And it's wet, so I can still mold it to the nail and adhere it to the nail. And I use the stick to kind of push it down into the acrylic. And to size it, I use nail clippers. And I just see the overlap that I need to remove with the clippers, and I just clip it away real easy to get the money sized up. Then, since the tip never really sticks good, what I always do is put a little bit of nail glue right underneath there and then just press it down with the orange wood stick so it's smooth and laying flat against the nail, so it's not too bulky when you're doing the inlay. Next step is just to begin sculpting over the money until you get your desired effect that you're looking for. And I'm just gonna do that now with some clear acrylic, and I'm just gonna continue. Okay, so now what I'm doing is adding some pink acrylic to the top, and that's the extreme pink acrylic, the ASP acrylic I got at Sally's, and that's the extreme pink color. And I just added some of the red pigment, and you can add the pigment in to make it a little bit more darker. In this case, I wanted it just a little bit more pink, so I'm adding that now and just smoothing out any edges, any creases that I see, just to make sure I have a smooth finish so I don't have to file too much at the end. And you just want to continue this process on all 10 nails. Just the same thing, applying the clear acrylic first, making sure that the money is wet, and then sculpting on top to inlay the money into the acrylic, and adding the pink for the color at the top of the nail bed. And the brush that I'm using is, this is a large, I believe it's the number, shoot, I have to look, I don't know, but it's the sable brush, and it's pretty big, so I like it because it makes me work faster. So right now I'm doing the filing, and I'm just using a 100 grit black rectangle file I got at Sally's, and I'm just removing all the loose acrylic, or the acrylic that may have been stuck to the side walls. And I'm also going to shape the free edge of the nail too with this file. Then I'm going to go ahead and take my electric drill, and I'm going to smooth out the nail and shape it out just to make sure that everything is smooth. And I'm going to go around the edges just to make sure that the acrylic is smooth around the cuticle area. And the trick with the electric file is not to apply pressure, and don't hold it at a sharp angle. And that should alleviate any problems that you got with using the electric drill. And this is not even a real powerful drill. I just got this at Sally's for like $35, but it does the job, so I'm gonna stick with it. Now I'm just gonna buff the nail out with the polar block. You can also get this at Sally's, and it gets the nail real smooth. Now that you have completed your set, just apply a cuticle oil. Just any cuticle oil would be nice, you can get at Sally's, and then wash your hands with the antibacterial soap. Now you can start your art. What I'm using is some Sushi Beet. It's probably not how you pronounce it, but that's the clear sealant that I like to use, and I'm going to just apply that to the nail. And I'm just going to use some rhinestones to add a little bit of decoration to this set. And I'm just using some square diamonds just to kind of add, you know, a little bit of jazz, a little bit of sassiness to this set, so it's not just plain money tips, but plain money tips will look nice too. So what I'm doing is just taking an orange wood stick while the nail polish is still wet, and I'm picking up the stones and then applying them to the nail. And you can do any kind of design you want. I'm just kind of freestyling it. I'm not really making nothing particular I had in mind. I'm just kind of adding rhinestones as I go. My polish got kind of dry at the tip there, so have to make sure that's stuck. And right on that middle finger, I just got George Washington face on that picture. I thought that was cute. So on this nail, I think I'm going to just go straight across with some round diamonds. And I'm just going to continue on all 10 fingers until I got like a little rhinestone design across. I'll pull down the cloud for you.